Our Excel podcast episode 1994, Sort Excel Subtotals. And go ahead and subscribe to the playlist. I'll be podcasting this entire book. And welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we're going to talk about subtotals, a great feature that's been around since Excel 97. I have data here. I make sure to sort the data by customer. Hundreds of rows of data, lots of customers. And when I go into data and then subtotal, at each change in, they always want a subtotal by the leftmost column, but you can change that, each change in customer. They offer 11 functions here, sum, count, average. As long as your rightmost column is numeric, they're going to choose sum. Choose the three columns there. If you want every customer on their own page, page break between groups, click OK. All right, and then what we get is every time the customer changes, we get a new subtotal row that was added. At the very bottom, we even get a grand total. All right, that grand total is hard to do, but thanks to the subtotal function. But over here on the left-hand side, we have three new buttons, group and outline buttons. That number two view, that is the beautiful view of the data. All right, so I was in Springfield, Missouri, and someone asked me, is there a way to sort the subtotals so that way the largest customer is at the top? All right, and I started to think about this, and it's like each of these customers has several records associated with it. If I would somehow sort this and get the largest value to come to the top, well, you know, it would be a formula pointing at rows above us, and it's not there anymore. But Derek was back there in row 6. Derek says, hey, no, wait, you can do this. Just choose one cell in the revenue column and click Z to A. I'm like, Derek, I don't think that'll work. There's no way that'll work. He said, Derek says, trust me, just try it. All right, so here I'm going to sort this. And Wagmore Dog Store San Antonio comes to the top, but they don't come to row 2. It comes to row 49. And if we go look at the number 3 view, which shows us all the detail, you see that Excel brought all of Wagmore Dog Store detail records and that total along. It didn't sort within these records. It just brought them in their original sequence. It took, I always say it's an entire chunk of data. And then BradEdgar.com came up as the second group, and then CPA Self-Study as the third group. I was blown away. I couldn't believe that Microsoft actually did something like this, did the right thing in order to get things to sort. And let's think about if we would sort by customer, right? The grand total is going to come up somewhere into the middle of the data, right before Hartville Market and Marketplace and Flea Market. But if we click A to Z, they're smart enough to keep the grand total at the bottom, and it doesn't swing up in between F keys and Hartville Marketplace. Absolutely amazing, amazing trick. And it's just one of the 40 tricks in the book. Go ahead, click that I in the top right-hand corner. Cheap to buy the book, $25 in print. $10 ebook. Great reference to all of these podcasts. Again, thanks to my friend Derek Fraley in Springfield, Missouri for this trick and several others that he's given me along the way. First, you add the subtotals, use the group and outline button to show only the subtotals, sort descending by revenue, and Excel sorts chunks of records. Or you can sort again by customer, and the grand total goes back to the bottom. Great, great trick. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.